government of Ghana has had occasion in the past to express its concern and displeasure over breaches by some British firms of the United Nations mandatory sanctions imposed on Rhodesia. Once again, British firms have, according to worldwide press reports, admitted responsibility for deliberate assistance to the regime of Rhodesia, which is, by common consent, not only illegal, but also blatantly racist and brutally oppressive. Ghana again deplores this flagrant connivance and hopes that the British government will ensure that no British firm ever again supports racism and the repression of African peoples through such acts as the British Petroleum and Shell companies have been accused of. Mr. President, it is regrettable that as we debate this question of Zimbabwe, Mr. Ian Smith is in the United States. The government of Ghana hopes that his visit will not lead to a breach of the sanctions imposed by the Security Council.